beautiful people, it's another beautiful Sunday. Today, we're going to do a comparison video among photo background removal AI online apps versus Photoshop's new feature called Subject Tool. This is a quick selection tool to select subject and mask it. Let's see which tool will give us a better result. Let's do it. Let's try first the Photoshop. Open a photo in the Photoshop or drag and drop the photo to Photoshop. Go to Select on the menu bar and click Subject. You can see here that the subject is being selected. Click the folder icon under the layer to mask the layer or the subject. In Photoshop, we can use other tools to enhance the result, but this time, I just want to show you the quickest background removal method, which is the Subject tool, and I do this to be fair with our judgment of the AI online apps. So here is the result in Photoshop, and let's proceed to online apps. First AI background photo removal online app we're going to try is removebg.ai. Let's drag and drop the photo to the app. Let's wait until the process finished. Now, here's the result. You can see the edges of the subject are rough. It looks like the contrast is a bit high. So let's try another app. And the second online app we're going to try is removebg. Here's the result. You can see on the screen the result is more acceptable than removebg.ai, but it doesn't mean that I am already contented. So let's try another online apps and after, let's do our verdict. The third AI online background removal app we're going to try is hotpot.ai. Here's the result. This is definitely not acceptable for me. This is worse than the first online app we tried. So let's move to the fourth one. The fourth app we're going to try is pixcut by wondershare. Here's the result. So far, this is much cleaner than removebg and Photoshop. The last one I tried is Social Book, and I will show you the result. Personally, I don't like the result, but it doesn't mean that other people don't like it. Still, it depends on one's taste. Here are my top three: pixcut by wondershare, removebg, and lastly, Adobe Photoshop. If you are not an advanced user of Photoshop and if you don't have one, then online apps I mentioned earlier are highly recommended. Those online apps are free, but if you want to download a high-definition copy of the photo, then you have to upgrade to a monthly subscription or pay for a one-time fee. Hope this short video is useful to you and please support our channel by subscribing to it. If you have some clarifications and subject you want me to tackle, please leave your comment below. Thank you. If you have knowledge, let others light their candles at it. Have a blessed Sunday, everyone. This last part of the video, I would like to dedicate to our dearest members who are supporting our channel through joining our membership perks. And I hope you will continue supporting us.